What is up, guys? Travis Blanks here, ready to talk about this year's Evo that just happened for the last weekend. It was amazing. It was awesome. There was a lot of big upsets and a lot of shocking moments, but, you know, I got to give props and I got to give my congrats to Infiltration, Sonic Fox, and some of the others, especially a big shout out to Chris G and Hungrybox for winning their tournaments that they was like they will always get so close to in the past Evos, but they end up falling short. This year, both of them was able to both win theirs. Chris G winning Ultimate Marvel vs. Capcom and Hungrybox winning Melee. So congrats to everybody who out there won. Congrats to those guys. And mainly right now, I want to go ahead and talk about the news that have been happening as this weekend for all fighting games in general. Now, go ahead and get in the first thing out of the way. I'm just going to say, Meyer, dead or alive, I feel like I need to return. I just need to return. Anyway, on the other known basis that's away from that, alright, starting with the first thing that really came out to us with a big news was Capcom announcing a special set of DLCs. These DLCs were Chun-Li in an elegant rich snooty outfit, and so was Cammy. Cammy was an elegant, like, rich snob type of outfit. And then a big giant stage that was represented being the thing for the Evo and the Pro Tour, pretty much Capcom Pro Tour. All this was going for Capcom Pro Tour. I'm considering this the elephant in the room because it is very overpriced. It is very expensive. I'm sitting here looking at the price and I'm like, oh my god, y'all expect everybody to pay $10 for a stage? No, who would do that? No, I would not do it. I'll just buy the Cammy and Chun-Li things because I kind of like them. And also, apparently, there's supposed to be a DLC, a mystery skin later on. Everybody's thinking it's going to be like an Eva Ryu or Akuma, but for some reason, I have a feeling it could be this. Sorry, guys. I just got that feeling. I just got the feeling in my system. Also, that was like showing off was Kings of Fighters. Kings of Fighters, I'm now kind of interested in. I know in my reaction video I talked trash about it, calling it a PlayStation graphic-looking game, but, you know, it's looking pretty interesting. It's looking more fun for me and coming in the fighting scene. There was also Guilty Gears. Guilty Gears announced that Dizzy is going to be out on Monday. So, the very next day, I was like, yo, now I got to find a way to get myself Guilty Gear. Also, that what was also announced in Tekken 7, Bob was returning to Tekken 7, and Raven Master, Raven's boss? No! I don't want Raven's boss. I want Raven, the original dude. I want him back.
I hope your affairs are in order. Mission
complete. Okay. I'm a little bit interested. Make a note. Get Tekken 7. Don't judge me. As well as, not only that, Capcom also announced that they were going to do some stuff with the Rage Quitters, even though they done said that multiple times and still nothing happened. I still get some Rage Quitters in my matchups. And, you know, we're supposed to eventually be able to buy the colors from Survival Mode, because we all know, come on, that was pretty dumb of them to make it that hard for us to try to get colors. So they're apparently going to be later on in the store for shop and stuff. They're going to do a few more tweaks and stuff to make the game a lot better. And all that's going to come, like, after the whole Pro Tour, Capcom Pro Tour. So we got a few couple of more months to, like, endure with all this. So there's that. And Jury's coming out later on at the end of this month. So that was pretty all right. But other than that, like, I actually really enjoyed this year's Capcom Pro Tour. Like I said, there was a lot of upsets. I thought, you know, Daigo was going to go out a little farther, but apparently he didn't. He got stomped away by, I think, Go One. Go One got him. and a few more people like surprised me. Like it is, I'm proud of Chris G. You know, he really wanted that, and I think a lot of people didn't want him to because he was a projectile zoning spamming type of dude. So, you know, but hey, I'm happy for him. I'm happy for all the winners and, you know, all the people who did their best and managed to get the top 8. Congratulations to y'all. I wish I can do it, but, you know, maybe I might join the fall class. I might try to do something. But, you know, let me know what you guys think. Did you enjoy this Evo? What was the biggest news out of everything that was announced that you liked the most? You know, leave a comment or video response, and make sure you hit that subscribe and like button. And without any other sayings, this is Chaz Blanks signing out.